Hi guys, in this video I'm going to explain how to encrypt our data using SDS algorithm. SDS algorithm is a two-round encryption technique. So in each round we are using a different key values. So we require two keys to perform this encryption. In my previous video, I explained how to generate the key using a SDS algorithm. So the two key values are, the first key one value is 10100100 and the key two value is 01000011. Coming to the encryption technique, initially the size of my plain text is a 8-bit number. So apply a IP table on the 8-bit number. So the output is a 8-bit number and divide the 8-bit number into two halves, the left half and the right half. Apply a EP table on the right half so that the output will be 8-digit number. In the EP table, the input is a 4-digit number and the output is a 8-digit number. Now perform the XOR operation between the output of EP table and my key one value. Then the output is again an 8-digit number. Now again, do two equal halves is nothing but a for left half and the right half. Now I need to put them into the S boxes. There are two S boxes, S0 and the S1. The left half will consider the S0 box and the right half will consider the S1 box. So the output of S0 box will be 2 digits and the S1 is also another 2 digits. So I'm going to combine the outputs of S0 and S1. I get the output of 4-digit number. Again, I'm applying a P4 table. So the output is a 4-digit number. Now consider the left half of a IP table and perform the XOR operation between the output of P4 and the left half of IP table. Again, I'm going to get the 4-digit number. Now consider the right part of a IP table and combine the output of a XOR and the right half of the IP value. Just swap those value. We get another key value, which is the output of my first round of encryption technique. In the second round of encryption technique, I'm going to consider the output of a first round encryption as an input value. And I am going to proceed in a similar, I'm going to encrypt in a similar manner, which I did in a first round of encryption. And the finally, I apply a 8-digit number on a IP inverse table, then I get a ciphertext. Coming to the encryption technique, in the first step, I need to consider a plain text. In this example, I'm considering a plain text as 0111010. In the second step, I need to put my plain text in the IP8 table and I need to permutate the bits. IP stands for the initial permutation. So this is my IP table. In my last video, I explained the tables or the functions which we are going to use in the SDS algorithm. So if the input is 1, then the output is 2. If the 2 represents the second value in my input, so I need to put the plain text into IP8. So this is my plain text and I'm considering as an input. So this is the input of IP8 table and the output will be 10101001. So if the output at first position will be the input value which is present at second position. So at the second position, the input value is 1. So the output at first position is 1. In such a manner, we need to find the output of a IP8 table and different tables. So the output in the step 2 is nothing but 10101001. So this is the output of IP table. And in the step 3, we need to break the IP output into two equal halves, the left half and the right half. In step 4, take the right half and put them into the EP table. So the value of right half is 1001 and I'm going to put this value into the EP table. So in the EP table, the input is a 4-digit number and the output is a 8-digit number. So that's the reason we called EP as expand and permutate. So I am expanding my input values. So the input is 1001 and the output is 11000011. So the output at the first position is nothing but the fourth position, the fourth value which is available in the fourth position of my input. In the fourth position of my input, it is nothing but a 1. So the output at first position, the value is a 1. The output in my fourth step is 11000001. Coming to the fifth step, now I need to perform an XOR operation between the output generated in my previous step and for the key 1 value. So the output generated in the previous step is 11000001 and the key 1 value is 10100100. After performing XOR operation, the output is 01100111. So this is the output in my step 5. In the step 6, I am going to split the output of an XOR operation into two halves. So the left half is 0110 and the right half is 0111. So the left half should be put into the S0 box and the right half to the S1 box. So these are the two S boxes which are available, and these are the constant S boxes for every example. So how we can put them into the S boxes? So let's consider a first half, nothing but a left half. In the left half, the first position and the fourth position represents the row, and the second position and the third position represents the column. In a similar manner, in the right half, the first position and the fourth position represents the row, and the second position, third position represents the column. So in the value of left half is 0110, and the first and last bits are nothing but 0 and 0. These will be row, and second and third are 11. So this will be a column number. So 00 is nothing but a 0th row, 11 is nothing but a third column. So the decimal value of 00 is 0, the decimal value of 11 is 3. So that's the reason in the S0 box, consider the value which is available at 0th row, third column. In my S box, so this is my 0th row and this is the third column. The value available at 0th row, third column is nothing but 2. So the binary value of 2 is nothing but a 10. So this is the output of S0. In similar manner, considering a right half value is 011, the first and last bits are 0 and 1, and the second and third bits are a 11. So first row, third column. The value available at first row, third column is 3. The decimal value of 3 is 11. So the output of S1 is 11. In the seventh step, we need to combine the S0 and the S1 values. So S0, S1 is equal to the 1011. In the step 8, I need to put them into the P4 table, and the result will be nothing but 0111. In this also a similar manner. So the value at first input is nothing but the output is second value which is available in my input. So at the first position of output, I need to consider the second value which is available in an input. So it's nothing but 0. And in the second position of my output, I need to consider the fourth value which is available at input. So that's nothing but a 1. So 0111. In the step 9, I need to perform the XOR operation between the output and the initial permutation left part. So the left part of initial permutation is 1010. So the 1010 available in step 3. So let's check in the step 3. So I'm going to the step 3. In the step 3, the left half is nothing but 1010. So I'm using that value in the step 9. So the output in my previous step is 0111 and the left part of IP table is 1010. I need to perform the XOR operation. After performing XOR operation, the output is 1101. Now get the right half of initial permutations which is available in step 3, nothing but a 1001. The output is nothing but 1101. So just combine those both values. So 1101 should be combined with 1001. The final output is 1100100. Now again, break them into two halves, the left half and the right half. In the final step of first round of encryption, we need to swap those the those value, it means that the left half value should be the right half and the right half value should be the left half. Finally, the output of my first round of encryption is nothing but 1001 1100. And the final, in the second round, so that nothing but a 13th step. Now let's take these halves and once again start the same procedure from step 2 or from our initial permutation. But be careful on using key in this stage. In this stage, we need to use the key value as a key 2. So what's my output? 1001 1100. So remember this output, and we need to start using these two halves from the step 2. So in the step 2, I'm passing the output of the first encryption technique into the IP table, and I need to proceed the all the steps. And at the fourth step, at the fifth step, I need to perform the XOR operation by using a key 2 value. This is the only one difference between the first round of encryption and second round of encryption. Guys, just you perform the second round of encryption and check the answer. So after performing the second round of encryption, the output will be 3110 3110. So guys, you must get this output value, then only you performed the second round of encryption in a perfect manner. So the final step of the encryption is nothing but we need to put the output of second round encryption into the IP inverse table. So how we can generate IP inverse table is explained in my previous video. So the output of IP inverse table is nothing but 4135728 6. Here the input is the my output of second round of encryption. This is my input. So this is my input, and the output is nothing but 0111101. So this output is from the IP inverse table. So the first position of the first output value should be the fourth value in my input. The fourth value in my input is nothing but 0. And the second output value should be the first position of my input value. It's nothing but 1. So 0111101. This is my ciphertext. In such a way, we need to perform the two round of encryption for the SDS algorithm. Thank you guys.